Hello, and welcome back to Minecraft Survival. This is part 64. Last time, we started, well, I guess not started, we finished creating the dome part. It is almost night. But we finished creating the dome part of the second dome, which will eventually be the library, which is what I want to work on today. But before that, I left my character at the auto farm, or the auto fish farm, for about 7 hours, as you can see by the fact that I am currently level 57. And out of everything I got, there's two books that I'm really excited about over here. But out of everything we got that's not those two books, we got Efficiency 4, which I want to add to my shovel. Which, one thing I really want to quickly say is, I made a second shovel that has Unbreaking 3 instead of Silk Touch. So I'm thinking I'm going to put this Efficiency 4 on this Efficiency 4 to get Efficiency 5. Either that or I'll put it on my pickaxe and get the pickaxe is like 10 times better. Oh wait, no, it already has efficiency 5. Never mind, it's going on the shovel. Anyways, then we got feather falling, that's neat. This has a lot of stuff. Power, sweeping edge, luck of the sea, fortune. Really put that on anything. Sharpness, just sharpness. Sharpness 4, even better. Knockback 2, protection, fortune, simple stuff, looting. Efficiency, Frostwalker, but none of that compares to these two books right here. That's right, we got mending books, finally. So, this one, not too happy about, because it is mending, but it has Curse of Binding on it, which means probably gonna put that one away. I'm not gonna use it. But, for this mending book, I'm going to take my super shovel. Actually, no. Yeah. I'm gonna take my super shovel. And I'm going to put mending on it for only 5 levels. Wow. And then if I have the levels, I'm also going to put efficiency 4. There we go. Now I have the best possible pickaxe. That is a shovel, not a pickaxe. And just because I can, I'm also going to put sharpness 4 on my sharpness 4 sword to get it up to sharpness 5. I think this is the best the sword can be now. Alright, a max sword. Oh wait, no, it could have a fire aspect. Oh well. So, anyways, as you can see, we have a lot of books. So we really need to make the library soon. But before we start actually making it, I'm gonna first sleep. Because it's always nighttime. I really need to start waiting until it's daytime before I make the videos, because it's always, like, almost nighttime as soon as I'm about to do something. But I'm going to take the slow route over to the area, because now, as you can see, we have two domes. That one is completely finished. It's got a wood floor in it. I didn't really do anything else. It currently only has torches in it. But if we just go down there real quick, we can see that it is entirely finished. Well, I guess not entirely. Well, I guess not entirely. Oh yeah, something I forgot to mention. I finally added glowstone up at the top of the domes so that it's not all dark. Now bats shouldn't continuously spawn. Finally fixed it. But anyways, now in here, this is where the library is going to be. I really need to start planning out how I want it to have it. How I want it to have it. I said that weird. I'm thinking how I'm going to have this is I'll maybe have the walls mostly covered in books with a few areas for windows. Then I'll have that level be a floor, or maybe that level, I don't know. And then up there I'll have more books in the middle, either in the middle or on that wall. I want the entire thing to just be a big map. Like from there down over just that entire thing, I want to be a map. Because I think that would be a really cool thing to have. So, yeah. That is what I'm gonna do. And also, off camera, I finally got a bunch of wood, so now we don't have to deal with not having oak wood. Whoa. Oh, that's interesting. This is a slime chunk. Awesome, I should have used... wish I had looting on the sword. But anyways... Okay, that's actually really cool. I didn't think that would be there. So I guess we're gonna have to deal with slimes in here. That's fine. First question. Should the second floor start there, We're there. Thinking there. Alright, yeah, this is gonna look cool. So, I'm thinking I'm gonna add another layer all the way around before I start actually adding in the pillars to hold it up. And I'm thinking also that I want to get rid of anything there, but I might end up just putting a map here. That could look real cool too. Alright, yeah. It's kind of got like an ellipse shape. Looks pretty nice. I'm thinking, do I want to have a staircase, or would I want to have ladders? I don't know. I'm going to put in the pillars, then I will decide. This might actually end up becoming one of my favorite rooms in the building. I mean, I know I only have two so far, but this is really cool. So I think what my plan's gonna be is back here, I'll have a big map, as I said before. In the middle, I was actually thinking I would have an enchantment table. Like, find the very center block and then have something similar to what I have down there. And then I was also thinking I might have, like, the walls kind of surrounded with books. Maybe a few rows of books here and there. I'm thinking I'll put a couple ladders here and here, just to make it simple. Maybe the same thing on the other side. And let's see, I think that's it. Oh yeah, and then upstairs, I wanted to add chests going all the way around. And that is where I'm going to store all of my book, or all of my enchanted books. So I'll be able to tell what I'm doing. All right, I added a little fence around here. Next thing I'm gonna do is, I guess I'll find the direct center and mark out the area that the table will go. And I think everything else I have to do involves just bookshelves. Okay, there is a cave down there. Oh, it was a good thing that I brought a second pickaxe. But I was not expecting a cave. Just gonna close that up. Might have to deal with that in the future, but for now, I am not gonna. I'm actually thinking I might just move the enchantment table from in there over to here and replace this one with, or replace that one with something else. Because this is a much more suiting place for it. Probably actually just put a torch on. Nah, it's not as high of a light level. I'll put one there now, but eventually I'm gonna have to change that. Alright, I have learned that I am very bad at placing bookshelves. I'm pretty sure just about every bookshelf I placed, I broke, and then ended up being like, oh, well, I guess I now have to go remake the bookshelves. But I'm thinking what I'm going to do is I'm going to have them 3 high, because I want to have that little slit right there where a bit of light can come in. Guess it won't really be much, but I think it looks nicer. And then from here, I'll just have these 3, then I'll have this wall covered. This wall will be the one with the map over here. I'll have the same kind of thing. Maybe here will be covered as well. Yeah, that'll be covered as well. And yeah, I guess once I have that done, all I need to do is just start moving stuff. I'll have to figure out what I'm putting in here later, but for now I'll just have a little hole with a torch. Hey, look. I got up from the ocean in the perfect time to see a sunrise. This is kind of hard to see it unless, well, maybe I can see it from the top of the tower. Why did I say that like a question? Yeah, there we go. Now we can see it. Minecraft really is a pretty game. Hey, I can see my house from here. Bigger slime. Whoa, it's a big slime. Hello, big slime. And I guess from now on, this place has 2 functions. Not only is it a slime, or not a slime farm. Not only is it a library, it's like a mini slime farm. Just get all the slime you need. I have 9 slime balls. This is way more effective than any slime farm I've made before. It's kind of sad whenever a library is more effective than a slime farm. Alright, this place is starting to come along. Guess I can go ahead. Where's the glowstone? There it is. Go ahead and put the enchantment table in here. There we go. Now this is level 30, right? If I put this in here, yeah, that goes up to level 30. Which means, I believe the bottom floor? Oh no, we still have the map. But that will be done in a later time, because I don't think we have time to make it that big of a map. But anyways, I think the only thing we have left are putting in the chests upstairs. Alright, I have a bunch of chests up here. I overestimated the amount of chests I'd need by a little bit, just like 40. But anyways, I have a bunch of chests, and I'm going to put item frames above every single one, and I'm going to give some kind of item above it that kind of tells what it's used for. So let's say it's sharpness. I might put, I don't know, quartz above it or something. I don't know. Or it's fortune, I might put an emerald or a diamond above it. So that's my plan for up here. Now I'm going to go around, add a few little decorations here and there, and I will show you what it looks like once I'm done. Alright, I just finished adding decorations all around. I actually realized that I don't really need lights up in the top area, because I have these lights here. So that was pretty nice. Down here, I added a few desks here and there. I forgot to grab any flowers to put in the flower pots, so I will have to do that off camera. I added a couple chairs with desks, like this little chair with a side table. This is another chair, just a regular table. Only the big tables have flower pots on them. Here it is. I just have a chair. You can just sit here, watch your friends, maybe just read, you know, like a normal person. I didn't really do anything up here. I was thinking maybe I'd add some paintings, but then I thought, nah, I'm gonna have enough stuff up here. It'll just feel kind of overcrowded. So I didn't really do anything up here. So I guess, other than the, whatchamacallits? I don't remember what those are called. Item frames, sorry. Other than the item frames and the gigantic map that I'll be putting in here at some point, this library is pretty much finished. So that is where I'm going to end off the episode. I hope you enjoyed. Next time, we will work more on the giant potion brewing dome and hopefully get that finished, or at least, you know, built. Bye.